6 minutes into Game 5 here Tuesday night, Montreal center Jesperi Kotkaniemi made a tentative play in the neutral zone. The result was a late line change and a scoring chance for Vegas. If Kotkaniemi was feeling a bit tense in the moment, he could be forgiven. He is, after all, only 20 years old. The game and series were tied. Momentum there for the season. But on his very next shift, Kotkaniemi was much more resolute. When Josh Anderson made a daring dash to the goal mouth and Marc-Andre Fleury made the initial save, Kotkaniemi was there for the rebound. Montreal had a 1-0 lead, one that they never gave up. By the time the night was done, the Habs had goals from their three youngest players, Cole Caulfield, Kotkaniemi, and Nick Suzuki. They also got a goal from their oldest player, Eric Staal, who scored on Marc-Andre Fleury, the only player drafted ahead of him in the NHL draft of 2003, 18 years ago this week. The Habs also got a key assist from their second oldest player, Corey Perry, on the goal scored by Caulfield. Kotkaniemi now has 9 career playoff goals, ranking second only behind Claude Lemieux among Habs players before turning 21 years old. In that way, that generational dynamic of the Habs Game 5 win was so perfect for a franchise that last won the Stanley Cup in 1993, more than 7 years before both Caulfield and Kotkaniemi were born. The blueprint for this win seemed strikingly similar to so many triumphant nights for Montreal in these playoffs. They are a perfect 10-0 when scoring at least 2 goals. Carey Price was brilliant throughout the night, especially late, with an incredible save in the second half of the third period on the doorstep against Riley Smith, when it seemed as though the Golden Knights were gaining some momentum. As it was, late in the third period, the home crowd here at T-Mobile Arena could be heard booing the Golden Knights, that team that was so heavily favored when the series began. In the waning seconds, Golden Knights coach Peter DeBoer could be seen speaking animatedly to his players on the bench, a group that will now face elimination in Montreal Thursday night. And then, in the final moments, we heard the crowd that had come here to support Montreal, those 1,000 or so fans in Habs jerseys, chanting loudly as their team will play Thursday on home ice with a chance to win and return to the Stanley Cup Final for the first time since 1993.